Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. Odontoma, also known as odontome, is a benign tumor originating from a tract containing dental tissues like mature enamel and dentin with variable amounts of pulp and cementum. They are formed after the stage of histodifferentiation, but before the stage of morphodifferentiation during the bell stage of a tooth germ. Odontomas are slow-growing lesions and are composed of well-differentiated normal tissues that has grown in a disorganized pattern. That's why they are called hamartomas, meaning that they are not true tumors. Because a true tumor is a mass of abnormal tissues, the growth of which exceeds and is uncoordinated with that of normal tissue. The cause or etiology of odontomas up to date is unknown. They are the most common odontogenic tumors and are divided into two types. The compound and complex odontoma. Compound odontoma is composed of multiple small tooth-like structures having enamel, dentin, pulp and cementum in a well-organized pattern, just like a normal tooth. Under radiography, it looks like a bag of teeth. On the other hand, the complex type, as the name suggests, has a complex structure. It consists of an irregular mass of enamel and dentin, with the entire mass having a sunburst-like appearance. Unlike compound odontoma, it does not resemble a normal tooth in structure, in that enamel and dentin are arranged in a disorganized pattern. Occasionally, some odontomas may show features of both compound and complex types. Let's talk about some clinical features of odontomas. Odontomas represent about 7% of all odontogenic neoplasms and usually occur among children or young adults, preferably in their second decade of life, with the mean age being 14 years. There is no sex predilection, and the majority of lesions are asymptomatic. Since these lesions are asymptomatic, they are discovered on a routine radiographic examination during an investigation for the delayed eruption of adjacent teeth or retained primary teeth. Once the tooth structures in an odontoma reach their maturity, the lesion does not grow further in size, but the lesion does persist if left untreated. The compound type is twice as common as the complex type. Although the lesion can develop in any area of the jaws, the compound type occurs most often in the anterior maxilla, in the incisor and canine region, and the complex type most often develops in the posterior region of either jaw, in the premolar and molar regions. Coming to the radiographic features, the radiographic features of the compound and complex types differs from each other in so many aspects. The compound type appears as a collection of tooth-like structures of varying sizes and shapes surrounded by a narrow, thin radiolucent zone. They look like a bag of teeth and are commonly located between the roots of the erupted permanent tooth or above the crown of an impacted tooth. Odontomes that are located in between roots of a tooth are usually smaller in size and do not impede tooth eruption. However, odontomas located above developing teeth cause impaction of associated teeth. The complex type appears as a radio-opaque, calcified and irregular mass. And just like the compound type, it's surrounded by a narrow radiolucent zone, which represents its capsule. Compound odontomas, because of their resemblance to a tooth, are easy to detect in a radiograph. However, complex types are hard to diagnose on a radiograph, and due to their irregular shape, they are sometimes mistaken for an osteoma. In histopathology, a fully developed compound odontoma consists of multiple structures resembling small single-rooted teeth, also called denticles. These denticles are embedded in a fibrous tissue stroma. Morphologically, most of the denticles do not resemble the tooth of the normal dentition, but the tissues like enamel, dentin, pulp, and cementum are organized in a similar fashion of a tooth. The number of denticles in compound type varies from as few as 2 to 3 or as many as 20 or 30. In complex odontoma, mature tubular dentin comprises the bulk of the lesion. This tubular dentin is seen in closing clefts or hollow circular structures that contain the mature enamel removed during the decalcification process. A thin layer of cementum is often present around the periphery of the lesion. Odontomas are treated with surgical enucleation. They have the lowest recurrence rate. That's why their prognosis is excellent. If you think this video has really helped you, please do like and share the video. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell icon to get notified on each upcoming video. Plus, if you have got any questions or suggestions regarding this video, you may write them down in the comment box. Thank you for watching.